So I thought I'd make a short video just to show how sometimes some projects don't work out the way you had planned or had hoped, and sometimes you have a really good idea for a maybe it'll be a custom mod or a custom console you want to work on, and you'll have it all worked out in your head. You know all the parts you need, you know how it's all going to fit together, but when it actually comes to fitting the thing together, you run across some unexpected problem or some kind of technical issue that basically means you have to either rethink the entire project or just kind of scrap it all together. And that's kind of what's happened with one of my projects here. As you can see, I've got a couple of faulty Game Gears. I bought these on eBay, they're really cheap. But the plan I had was to basically create a kind of a hybrid handheld, custom handheld gaming system. And the way I was going to do that was completely gut one of these Game Gears here, but leave the controls in place. And what I'd bought was one of these devices, a Blaze handheld gaming system. And you get these in different versions. This is the Master System Game Gear version. You can see it's got the single D-pad and two buttons, so a perfect match for the Game Gear control scheme there. And what I'd planned to do was gut this and the Game Gear and install the innards from this into the Game Gear, while at the same time installing a new modern LCD screen. So this is the same type of screen that I installed in my Nomad, which I've got here. So you can see the Nomad, this is the same type of screen I fitted in that. So I was hoping to do the same for the Game Gear, but instead of using the original Game Gear hardware, because the Game Gear doesn't have a TV output, and getting them to work with modern screens is really difficult. There are projects you can do to get the Game Gear to output RGB, I think, but it's really complicated, and I just wanted a kind of quick, simple project here. And that's what I'd hoped for with this Blaze portable gaming system, because with these actually have a TV output on them. I'll show you this here. So this is the device. It's quite a lot smaller than the original Game Gear. You can see there's a video output on the top there, so you can actually just plug this into your TV, or like I had planned, you could plug it into this reversing monitor here. So I could have installed this into the Game Gear along with the innards of this device here, kept the original controls, I'd have had 30 built-in games on the Game Gear, and I'd have had a nice new modern LCD screen. The other thing I'd planned to do as well was install a modern rechargeable battery pack unit as well, so that would have all been encased in the Game Gear housing there. So it would kind of be like a hybrid handheld gaming system. But as you can see, I bought all the parts and everything, had it all worked out, but I ran into an unexpected problem just when I was testing it all out to make sure it all worked together. So probably the easiest thing to do is just to actually show you what the problem is. So I've got the Blaze handheld hooked up to that little LCD screen now, and you can probably tell what the problem is. You can maybe just about make that out, but there's some sort of strange letterboxing effect going on where you've got a border at the top and the bottom of the screen, which is kind of annoying. And I was sort of hoping that it was only for the menu screen that it was going to do that for, but unfortunately when I start up a game here, you can see it's exactly the same. It's actually a little worse. It's got a border down the side of the screen there as well. So that kind of put an end to my project. I was hoping that it would display in full screen, because it displays in full screen on the Blaze handheld here, so I was kind of hoping it would do the same for the LCD screen, but sadly not. And I could still go ahead and fit everything in here and just have it display at the incorrect aspect ratio, but I thought it maybe wasn't worth it in the end. What I'll probably end up doing now is I'll use the screen here and the battery pack to refurbish and modify that new or that old Nomad that I bought in a job lot just recently. So I'll use those parts for that, and I'll still keep these, and I still want to do a custom handheld with these, because I think it's a really good this is a really good kind of form factor to or device to make your own custom handhelds. There's tons and tons of room inside the Game Gear. You can quite easily fit one of these LCD screens in there. And if you've ever gone to the Deal Extreme website, you'll see that there's a whole ton of clone systems. Like you get there's a GBA clone, and there's a whole bunch of different handheld devices that will basically emulate all the different retro consoles. So one of the other kind of plans I've got is to maybe in the future buy one of those emulator devices and install it into one of the Game Gear systems here, and basically create the hybrid system I was talking about. I thought that could be quite a fun project, but for now this is one of the projects that didn't work out quite as I'd planned, but yeah, just thought I'd do a video on that. What I'm going to end up doing is probably selling this and reusing the parts for something else, but that's just an example of a project that hasn't worked out. The other thing I was going to say, a lot of people are always asking me about the Nintendo NES GameCube Fusion mod that I was doing. I don't know how long ago, it's probably about a year, maybe a bit more now. But I've never actually finished that project. It is still here. I've not thrown it out. It does work and everything. I've just not got around to finishing it. And I will get around to finishing it at some point. It's not like I've not actually run into any problems with this, other than I've just been kind of lazy, and I always seem to find other projects that distract me, such as this one and the various other mods I've been doing with the other consoles. But yeah, just a quick video there to show you how the your plans don't always work out the way you'd hoped. So thanks for watching, and I'll catch you again soon.